What's up, guys? It's Alec Jones My Cookies back with another video. So this is just gonna be kind of a quicker video, more of like an opinion-based video as to why K-rap isn't as big as K-pop, because I mean K-rap definitely has grown with K-pop as like the Korean like music genre kind of thing as a whole has grown. However, it will never be as big. So I hope you guys enjoy. Bye. So I think K-rap won't be as big as K-pop, and it will never surpass K-pop because K-rap obviously is usually one person. I mean, they do have collabs like Jessie. This video came out, I think, today or a couple days ago with Jay Park. And they have a lot of collabs, like more collabs are in the K-rap community than there are in the K-pop community. And it's because they're all pretty much solos, or I think there's a couple duos in there, but there's not really K-rap groups. It's more just K, just like a solo person in a K-rap, in a K-rap. Wow, good English. But if you guys couldn't tell, I'm like really sick right now. I'm really struggling. And that's why in K-pop, like, not even most solo artists don't ever get as big as the, like, K-pop groups. Like, if you were in a K-pop group, you have, like, a million times more chances to become famous than you do as a solo artist, because people, like, K-pop is just kind of built for groups, because they expect so much from artists in K-pop. Like, they want you to be able to sing, they need a rapper in the group, they need a dancer, they need a visual, and that's much easier to do with, like, six, seven-ish people than it is to do with just one person, because that one person has to do vocals, because, I mean, a song can be just rapping, but it kind of, most songs need, like, a chorus kind of thing, and a lot of rappers can't do that, if that makes sense. And it's very hard to perform as just one person because it just kind of, like, you never really get a break from the camera, if that makes sense. Like, you are just always the only person on camera. And even if you are tired or anything, you are the sole person that is on camera. Like, in a group, obviously the focus shifts. So, like, one second you're on camera, and then the next second you can, like, catch your breath and, like, stop dancing for a little bit because it's on your group member, you know what I mean? And so that's what is, I guess, appealing about a group, is that it looks so much better because there's so many people, and that, like, if one person is, quote, slacking, you could just move on to the next person. And also, like, they're easier to stand a group than it is to stand, like, one person, because there's so many different personalities in that group that you're likely to mix with, like, one of them at least. And if you're trying to follow a solo artist and you don't like their personality, it's really hard to, like, mesh with their music, if that makes sense. And another reason that K-rap is not going to be as popular as K-pop is that it's very controversial in its topics and its people. You know what I mean? Like, Jessie, who's on the screen now, she has fake boobs. You know, she likes to show off her boobs. At least I'm pretty, yeah, they're fake, yeah. I remember her saying that on TV show, but, like, she has very large breasts that are augmented, but she likes to show them off in tops and everything like that. Like, she likes to have, like, a nice little bra kind of thing, showing off her skin, and then, like, people like Jay Park and everything, they'll cuss in their videos, which is kind of controversial, I guess you could say. And they talk about drinking and, you know, like, sleeping with chicks, which isn't, I mean, it'll be mentioned in K-pop, but it's never really delved into like it is in K-rap. And, like, sexuality is kind of embraced in K-rap. Like, you can talk about girls and how hot they are without it being, like, weird. Like, do you remember that video that Jay Park came out with, like, I don't know, something mama or whatever, and everybody thought he was creepy? If he was, like, a K-rap artist, nobody would have even, like, bat an eye, because rap is traditionally more controversial than pop, even in, like, America, where, like, those genres kind of, like, originate. Like, in America, rap has always been more controversial than pop. I mean, it's kind of, like, mixing right now, but, like, it's always been very, like, rap has always been, like, the cussing, you know, girls, drugs, money kind of thing. And Korea is a very conservative country, and so they're not really about that. Like drugs, money, women, not really their thing. K-pop is much more safe, and they like that because it is safe and it is, I guess, easier to deal with in a way, you could say. I mean, if that makes any sense. And plus, K-rap is still kind of new. K-pop's been around for like ever, and I mean, so has K-rap, but it wasn't big. Like, it just now started getting big. Like, this video probably got me and a whole bunch of other people into K-rap because it was a YouTube music ad. Bro, this song is lit. Legit, go listen to it. But, like, this freestyle is amazing. But it introduced me to K-rap. I never knew it was a thing. Like, I was like, K-pop? Yeah, fine. But I never, like, got through my brain that there's other genres that are sung in Korean. I guess rapped, technically, but you know what I mean. Like, other Korean genres, I just never really thought that that was a thing, I guess. And I guess a lot of K-pop fans are kind of like that. They're kind of oblivious to the fact that K-rap is, like, a thing. It just kind of goes over their heads and they're not really aware of it, if that makes sense. Like, they're kind of ignorant to, like, K-rap. I mean, I guess, like, if you mention it to some of them, like, most of them have probably heard of it. Like, they've probably heard of Jay Park, Jessie, kind of thing. But it's just kind of weird that it's not as big as K-pop. Some of my favorite songs that I listen to that are, like, in Korean are K-rap songs because they're so much bolder and brasher. Is brasher a word? I feel like it's not, but we're gonna go with it. Like, they're so much bolder and more. I don't know how you'd describe it. Like, this video, like, look at all that gold in the background. Like, most K-pop videos are more muted. You know, they don't really have as much nudity. Like, do you see Jessie? Anything that Jessie's wearing in this music video would never. Like, GFriend could never. Twice. Ooh, Twice would rather die before they did something like this. You know what I mean? Like, it's very different than K-pop, and I kind of like that. Like, it gives you kind of a break, because I do like, honestly, I'm gonna be kind of weird here. Korean sounds really good to the ear. Maybe it's just because I'm a Koreaboo at this point, but like, Korean is a very, like, nice language. Like, Spanish, ooh, I love listening to Spanish, and I like listening to Korean because it's a very calming language, I guess you could say. And like, K-rap is very, it's very good to listen to. Because, you know, it doesn't talk about, well, I was just about to say it doesn't talk about women as much, but I, you know, just zoom in on that ass. But like, there are K-rap songs that aren't just about women and everything. I mean, like, this song, I love this song. It's very much about women. But I like that it's very bold. And it's very out there compared to K-pop. And I love that about it. You know what I mean? K-rap is just more confident and more bolder than regular K-pop. And that's, I think, the appeal of it really is that it's like American rap, but it's compared with the more tame K-pop, which makes it look crazier, I guess, in my opinion. If that makes any sense. I don't know. Maybe I'm just weird. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you guys enjoyed listening to me speak with my sick voice. Also, someone commented the other day that I have like an ASMR voice. I really hope this video doesn't scare you away from listening to my voice as ASMR. I love you guys. I hope you guys have a great day and aren't sick like me. And I love you. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Bye. Thank you.